Well, good morning. Let's stand and sing a hymn and a carol of our faith this morning. Oh, come, all ye faithful. Remember, last week I promised a world-class quartet, and I intend on keeping that promise. So, without any further ado, I introduce to you the Central Boys. I told you this, world class. Just world class. Well, this morning we're so excited to be able to be here with you and have you here with us as we go throughout this service. We have a special time of worship this morning, and it's through music and drama, and you'll see. I'll just leave it at that. But our prayer has been that this morning the Christmas story would come to life in your own life, and that it would come to mean something to you. Why did Jesus come? Why was he here? Why do we celebrate this time? So, without any further ado, I introduce to you a journey through the Christmas story.
Mommy, look, Santa left all these presents for us.
Wait, Lucy, wait. You need to wait on your dad. You know he wants to be here for you and your brother when you get to open your presents.
Dad, hurry. We're not getting any younger. Especially
you. All right, I'm coming. Hold your horses now.
Daddy, I'm so excited to see what Santa left for me.
Well, you know what, Lucy? It looks like Santa checked his list twice and found out you got all A's in that report card of yours.
He sure did, but first we're going to...
Wait a second. This isn't fair. She has two more presents under the tree than I do.
So? I have one less than you did last year.
Ben, Lucy, no fighting over presents this year. Today is a day of peace. Can we enjoy Christmas without arguing this time?
Now, kids, your mom is right. It's not about getting presents this year. We're celebrating much bigger and better things today.
Just asking, what could possibly be better than gifts?
Yeah, Daddy, why is getting gifts such a bad thing?
Well, you see, Lucy and Ben, the true meaning of Christmas is us receiving a gift, but it wasn't your ordinary gift. It was a king who was the best king in the world.
The best gift was actually not found under a tree, but rather a stable. Martin, why don't you hand me that Bible? It sounds like we all need a refresher on what the real meaning of Christmas is.
But, Mom, we want to open our presents now. We've waited all year for these.
We're going to get to open them soon enough, Ben. Just be patient.
You know, why don't we go ahead and start reading it now? Would y'all like that? I think so. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Cornelius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of lineage, and David to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child.
Yes, Lucy. They actually had a long journey to Bethlehem.
Oh.
so it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
In a manger? Why would they put a king in one of those?
Well, you see, Ben, Jesus was a king like no other king who humbled himself enough to come even when no one had room for him. No one knew of all the great miracles he was going to perform on this earth. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them. And the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring good tidings and great joy, which be to all peoples. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angels a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth, goodwill toward men."
Thank you.
So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told to them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told to them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told to them.
Oh, Whoa. Dad, that was an amazing story.
Daddy, what happened to Jesus?
Well, kids, Jesus lived the rest of his life performing miracles and teaching people how to love God and to love others. He became the greatest gift of all, salvation for all humanity. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, and whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. That, kids, is why he came.
First of all, join with me one more time to say thank you to the choir and the musicians and our actors, our technicians, and everyone that's had a part of this presentation. And to Collin, right here, thank you very much. Y'all stand up. Y'all stand up, everybody. All right, a lot of hard work went into this, a lot of practice and memorizing lines and things. And they do this for a reason. It's so we can remember truly what Christmas is about as we drive around and see lights and see all the sights and sounds and think about gifts and shopping and all those things that have become a part of our culture in the Christmas season. We need these things to remind us of the real reason for the season. And we want to take just a moment, not long, but because of the cross, to remember that Jesus came for a reason, and that reason is the reason for this season, and it's that Jesus came because we needed a Savior, as we heard earlier. But it's more than just believing. You can say, I believe the story is true. Scripture tells us that the demons believe and shudder. Scripture says we must believe and receive. It's just like you can believe that you have a gift under the tree, but if you don't receive that gift and open it, it'll never mean anything to you, and it'll never be yours. This morning, perhaps for the first time, you realize, you know, I've heard this story, and I even believe it's true, but this morning, you want to receive that gift into your life for the very, very first time. We want to give you an opportunity to respond. It's been the prayer of this choir and our church that this would be a time of worship and that God's Holy Spirit would be free to work this morning. So perhaps this morning, you would like to receive that gift of salvation, and we want to give you an opportunity to do that. We're going to sing just a song that you're very familiar with, and if this morning there's a decision you need to make or you want to receive Christ as your Lord and Savior, we're going to have our ministers here at the front, and we'll give you an opportunity to respond. Let's stand together as I pray as we move into this time of response. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this wonderful gift that you have given to us, and we pray this morning for that one or two or ever having it may be that's here with us this morning, God, that right now in this moment that your Holy Spirit is saying to them in their life that today is the day that they need to receive the gift of salvation into their life. Perhaps, God, they've been a church member or attended for a long time, but, Father, right now your Holy Spirit is saying they need to receive this gift into their life, more than just believing it's true, but letting it make that difference, being born again into your everlasting family. So, God, we give you this time of response, and may we have the courage and the faith to respond however you may lead us. For it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Adore him.
this happy rotation. Oh, sing, all ye bright hosts of heaven above. Glory to God, oh, glory in the highest. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him, Christ the Lord.
Amen. You may be seated.
Well, we're not done yet. We've got one more special thing for you. And so I'm going to... I know you're probably looking at your clock saying, we're getting out a little early today. We're just giving you a little bit of a lunch break, and we'll just hold you over longer next week. No, I'm just playing. But we got one more special song, so without any further ado.
What we've seen today in Bethlehem.
down and worship Him. We will worship Christ the King. I have seen the light shining in the darkness, bursting through the shadows.